So currently we're still in the planning stages of our homestead, and we're looking at trying to grow soil. And you see here, that's not our trailer. Actually, I put a request out on Craigslist for people to tell me if I can come by and pick up their compost. And this guy calls and says, I've got a trailer full of it, a lot of goat and alfalfa compost. Most of it is not near about composted yet, but oh man, I tell you what, our compost pile is still pretty puny at the present, and this is just a blessing right here. I tell you what, I did give him a little bit of money, about 25 bucks for his trouble, because he offered to actually bring it out from a neighboring city. So we're gonna get busy unloading this dude. Now, I'm not super familiar with this particular trailer, so it might take me some doings to get it open, but let's try it real quick. Tell you what, that's a mess of poop. Quite a bit right there. Let's open this dude up and see if we can't get busy. That's a mess of it, I tell you. I think a lot of this stuff looks like it's starting to compost pretty well. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move it right here, and I'm gonna move it over to that pile. And then I'll show you my progress as I go along. All right, well, shoot, that was a job. I tell you what, let me get this thing off my face. Well, I got this thing unloaded. I'm glad I did. Now comes the process of wetting it down. There's a lot to do in that regard. You want to keep this moist. If it's not moist, it won't decompose. If it doesn't decompose, you can't put it on your garden. It's too big. It'll be a nitrogen thief with all this alfalfa. So what we're doing right now is, of course, compost. And compost is the root to the whole gardening experience. If you grow good soil, you'll grow good vegetables, you'll grow good flowers, you'll grow good trees, you'll grow good everything, berries, you name it. The soil is where it all starts. If you have bad soil, then you don't have anything. So I'm going to water this down. We've got this thing emptied. I'm going to water this down. And I'm going to kind of explain while I'm doing that what our goals are over the next few weeks. Now, this stuff was pretty much dry as a bone when I pulled it out of that trailer. It was very dusty. And so what I want to do is I want to add a good amount of water and saturate this down pretty good. Not too wet, not too dry, just right, almost in the middle. Almost like good biscuit dough, if you know what I'm saying. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to water the outside down, then I'm going to pull it down upon itself to kind of level the top off. And when I do that, it's going to make more surface area. It's going to smooth it out. And what would thrill me is in the morning, this thing's steaming, maybe in the next couple of mornings anyways, we get enough biological activity to where this thing is starting to steam up on us. The videos have been few and far between because I've been working pretty good. I work as a school nurse, and I also work as a home health nurse. And with those two incomes, eventually I'll branch off into just one, and then we'll be able to do more homesteading. Now, if you've visited backtothehomestead.com, you'll see that the website is much different. If you haven't visited, head on over to backtothehomestead.com, all one word, and check it out. We've got more or less a blog site where we do articles, and there's a lot of different articles that I'm going to produce that won't have associated videos. I'm doing one right now as far as ways to get children involved in homesteading, and I'm using some of my own stories from my past and also some of my own experiences with my own children. So another thing we did is we started a Facebook page. You can head on over to backtothehomestead.com and you can see our page over there. You can like us or not, it's up to you, but it keeps up with the more immediate what's going on here on the homestead. Now, over the past few weeks, we've collected quite a bit of resource. You'll see here where we scored some wood. I guess you can say scored. It's a big pile of mess, really. I'll eventually cut this up and we'll burn this in the fire pit through the season and enjoy the ashes upon our garden. As a matter of fact, garlic likes a little bit of of ash to change that pH to that better environment that garlic likes to grow in. We did find some river rock, and I'll show you what I'm going to do with the river rock in the spring. Our comfrey is growing. I knew it would. Some of it is kind of hesitating, but you can see here how some of the plants are doing fine. They're starting to bud out, but winter is upon us. We're into fall quite well, and eventually these will all die back, and I'm crossing my fingers to see whether or not they come back in the spring. If they do, which I'm pretty sure most of them will, then I'll put them in a spot where I've decided. I mean, it's pretty much a blank slate throughout the homestead. We really don't know what we're going to put where, and I don't want to just ambiguously put something someplace and then regret it later. Sort of like this little raised bed here. It's a 2 foot tall and 8x4 bed, and I haven't put anything in it yet. I'm thinking about filling it full of Bartholomew's soil mixture, 1/3 peat moss, 1/3 vermiculite, 1/3 compost, and putting my garlic in that. And just, you know, if I decide to move it later, all I got to do is just pull it up and move the dirt someplace else, or use it as a, I don't know, side dressing someplace else. The rock still sits here, and it will until the spring when we decide on what to do with it all. So not much more to report here on Back to the Homestead. What we're going to do over the next few weeks is we're going to post that article on ways to get kids motivated in homesteading. And then we're going to work on a soil video. We're going to test our soil, and I'm going to show you how to test your soil so you'll know what kind of amendments to make into your soil. There'll be an associated blog post with that video. I'm going to try to get a garlic video made. I'm not real sure if I'm going to be successful there. If I don't do it this season, I'll definitely do it next season. Furthermore, check us out on Facebook, like I was mentioning earlier, Twitter, Instagram. You can find those links on backtothehomestead.com. I'm going to keep here on this compost pile, moistening it down, and then I'm going to go inside and I'm going to paint. When I don't work my two jobs, that's what I've been doing right now, is painting the inside of this house. I want it to look good, and I want to secure it down so I can get back out here and make some more videos and keep you guys updated. Beyond that, we'll see you next time on Back to the Homestead.
This.